They're both recorded?
Yep.
Okay.
Sync point.
One, two, trois.
Respect.
Perfect. Okay, guys, we are back to our capture card setup, but this time on a new capture card, Yelgato. So you're going to see everything in 60 FPS. And yes, this is a Kingdom Hearts 3 episode. We are on the 1.5, 2.5 collection. We're going to switch to Kingdom Hearts 3 in the middle of the episode, because with the capture card, we can do that.
Yep.
But for reasons unknown to Sam, but probably known to anyone who has played Kingdom Hearts 3.
Unknown.
I am going to... We're going to start with Kingdom Hearts 1. And Sam, just pay attention. All you have to do, Sam, is to pay attention and just take it in. I'm going to show you the intro to Kingdom Hearts 1.
Oh, damn.
Because that's where we started, and then we're going to end. We're going to watch the intro to Kingdom Hearts 3 as well.
Oh, nice. Oh, how far we've come.
Yeah, right?
Jesus, how far I've come.
Yeah. Oh, man. So just pay attention. Take it in. Feel it. Listen.
Yeah.
See.
I've been having these weird thoughts lately.
Weird. That should just be a meme, just the word weird on the screen.
Or not.
Is any of this for real or not? Yeah, that what is a meme is that whole phrase. Is any of this for real or not? Because I you know the or nah meme?
Oh, yeah.
Where the girl's just like this. Yeah, I saw one where she edited with Sora's hair. And it's like, I've been having this weird thought lately. Or is any of this for real? Or nah. I've talked about the symbolism here, how the ocean and the water in Kingdom Hearts represents darkness.
Mm-hmm.
It's very... It's not, like, subtle at all, but it is something that a lot of people miss, because really, I just think... I don't mean to be patronizing when I say this, but I just think, gamers take things a little too literally.
Because these are not people who, you know, tend to pay attention in English. All the gamers have to go back to English.
I don't think it's a problem to not realize the symbolism, because also this game is for kids, so kids wouldn't realize
no,
it either.
No, it's generally not a problem in almost any game to not get the symbolism. But, you know, like, it depends on what you mean by not a problem.
I think it's a problem when it comes to, like, major plot points, but I'm talking about, like, this example right here. But I do say, thing is, when you get, like, simple symbolism, right, like that, then some, you know, every once in a while someone will be like, oh, I just realized what the symbolizes, right? And then anybody who knows what symbolism is will be like, oh, yeah, duh, like, that's not very subtle. And then you get a bunch of people who are like, oh, that's so cool, and a bunch of people are like, oh, yeah, I knew this. And it pretty much just becomes, like, annoying on both sides.
Yeah.
Which is why I'm not trying to patronize anyone here, but I also think that you should, like, try to be more literate, just to,
I think people forget.
I like this shot where, like, it reveals the stained glass under it.
Yeah.
You
know, this, games are media just like anything else, you know? I mean, games are kind of just... You know, movies and music and
I could show you a little more here, but not really worth showing it right now. I'm just going to close this game because that's about it.
for the first time, y'all are actually seeing like the PS4 menu. My PS4.
Yeah, so Sam got the limited edition Spider-Man PS4, so that's his PS4 menu. And we are going to we also get these games physically, so we're going to remove that disc.
Remove the disc. Ah, what a series. So we've now inserted the KH3 disc.
Yep.
And then I guess I'll, if you want to take the controller back.
No. This is all you. Okay. You're playing Kingdom Hearts 3. We're not sync pointing yet. We already sync pointed.
Yeah, we don't need to sync point.
Yes, right. So you go in.
All right, we ready?
Yep. You say that as if we're about to start recording. We're already recording.
I know, I'm just making sure you're ready.
I'm ready.
Oh, so yeah, this screen you guys have never seen before, this kind of the splash screen when it loads, because again, I don't think that can't appear on a PS4 recording, even if we wanted it to. Okay. Well, actually, the time doesn't matter in the first place, unless the capture card has.
I mean,
a
limit. We still don't want to get too long.
That's true. Yes, we don't want. We're not going to make this like 3 hours, but we don't have to. We don't have to follow a liberal time limit.
All right, so this is going to be, like, the last time you'll see this in a while. It's been a long time since you've seen it, so let's just take it in.
Yeah.
We saw the intro to KH1. I'm going to see everything here. The chess. Mm-hmm.
We now know the significance of the chess, now that I've beaten this game's story for the most part.
Yep, you know, it's Xehanort versus Ericus. Starts with Birth by Sleep. One thing that's really when you play Kingdom Hearts 3, you realize that Xehanort still always did consider Ericus his friend.
Yeah.
That's just kind of how he finally admits defeat at the end. Yeah. And that really makes it shows how far he's gone in Birth by Sleep, because he doesn't even react when he kills Ericus. He just kills him and he just doesn't care. So it's like you don't even realize that Xehanort actually still did consider Ericus his friend even after killing him.
Yeah.
And that also did properly put Ericus in the position to forgive him.
It made that whole scene hit harder.
Yeah.
It's kind of like when Ansem and Xemnas die in the XXX fight.
Yeah. I was talking to my friends about Ansem's final form of Kingdom Hearts 1. I don't know if I talked to you about this before, and you probably don't. You definitely don't know. But Ansem's final form in Kingdom Hearts 1 is extremely similar to multiple final bosses in the Final Fantasy series before 7. Mm. And so it's like one of my favorite final bosses, because they basically took a classic Final Fantasy final boss and they put him in 3D and put him in an action game. And that's Ansem's cool final form. I can show you after this recording.
You know, it's funny you say that. I guess, you know, like... you know, like, I'm thinking also about, like, Strangers of Paradise, which is...
Stranger of Paradise.
Stranger of Paradise, which is a game recently announced at E3.
Yes.
Which sort of dates this episode, but whatever. And happy Juneteenth, everybody. And it's, you know, Nomura is just kind of, like, the dude to do that, I guess. Because he's already put, like, Final Fantasy boss... Like that game is a Final Fantasy action game.
Yes.
Like, directly Final Fantasy.
It's a Final Fantasy 1 action game.
And I guess through Kingdom Hearts, he's gotten a lot of experience in putting Final Fantasy things in action games.
Also Dissidia.
Yeah.
Also Final Fantasy 7 Remake.
Yeah, it seems like whenever they want to do an action-y Final Fantasy project, they'll turn to him primarily.
So when I say Ansem is a classic Final Fantasy final boss, but in 3D and an action game, I don't mean Final Fantasy 1. Final Fantasy 1's final boss was not like that. And we will get to see him in 3D in Sierra Paradise because he is in the logo. His name is Chaos, and he's the person
the
that
Jack
wants to kill.
Is, yeah.
Whole point of the original Final Fantasy was to kill Chaos, so whatever. But like after that, they start looking exactly like Ansem did. Also, I say 3D because Final Fantasy VII stopped doing that. Sephiroth is not like that. Neither is anyone after that. Not to say that Sephiroth is extremely different. He's just not really like that specifically. And I'll just have to show you that later. So that's the intro to Kingdom Hearts 3, which we saw like 3 times on recording, I think, at this point. But let's get into it. Let's get into the actual game.
Hell yeah.
And the block cutscene, which you'll see eventually, but not immediately. There we go. That's what...
The secret episode.
The secret episode. Now, that is actually what you're going to do next. The game actually automatically kicks you into the secret episode when you beat Data Xehanort, but we just kind of close the game after that. Mm-hmm. I don't remember. If you hit load game, you either might automatically go into the secret episode, so just try that. Yeah, just load game and see if it goes into the secret episode. If it doesn't, then we'll just have to go from the menu. Yeah, no, it doesn't. But that's fine. You just
that's a good
go
thing,
to title
if
screen.
Anything.
Yes,
actually.
It is a good thing. Now Sam has not seen any trailers. Sam
yeah,
has not
I,
seen
I haven't the slightest idea what's going to happen.
Sam has not seen anything regarding the secret episode until just a few seconds. Oh yeah, she's there. Talk to her.
Yeah, she's here because I beat all the data episodes.
I'm
the data battles.
Sure, you'll find a clue inside your dream, dear.
Does she say anything else?
You know, Master Yen, Sid, and Merlin have been quite concerned about you, dear. I'm sure you'll find a clue.
Sam, did you think she'd be important?
No.
She's literally... I'm serious. She's literally plot important. She's like one of the most important characters now.
That's really funny.
Because it's just a Bimini property
fish. And the thing is, like, it's actually cool because I'm pretty sure that they still use the original voice actor too.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's really cool. All
right, title screen, right?
Yeah, title screen. And then we're going to go into...
Should probably save over the backup at some point, but we can do that later.
Yeah.
So where do we...
Actually going to increase your volume. Don't worry, it's not going to get picked up by the mic.
Okay. Downloadable content, right?
It's special.
Oh, special?
No, yeah, downloadable content. Mm. Secret episode.
Oh, man.
I'm getting goosebumps.
Oh, I have no idea what's going to happen. This is so... I'm, like, really hype. Because, you know, for the longest time, like, for, like, 30 episodes worth of content, we were just doing the data battles. So I knew vaguely what was coming. I mean, I didn't know what the battles were going to be like before I did the data battles, but I knew I was just doing data battles. So it's like, okay, you just know it's going to be a really hard boss fight in that same old arena.
Okay, before you hit X, Sam, the only advice I can give you is just see what happens, okay? See how far you can get. Like, you know, just do your best. Do your best. I think you'll go into a menu after this, so let's go.
All right, here we go.
All right.
What the fuck? All right.
Notice anything?
Why does Sora look like low quality?
That's an interesting way to put it.
He's like, it looks like he's still, like, it's like he's in his video game screen. It's like he's like in the computer still. I don't think there's anything I really need to change. Oh, well, there is the,
You got the master something.
Yeah, I don't know if I want to equip that. Where is it?
I think it's master necklace, right? No.
No, it's not. I remember, because it was a bangle or something. It was like a
it was red and black.
Yeah, that's the thing I got from beating Xehanort.
Is this even the right slot? Master something? I think it was Master, right?
It was Master something.
Is I don't think this is this then.
Oh, it's maybe it's an armor piece, yeah.
Mute had to replace Petite Ribbon, if anything.
Master Belt.
Yeah, so lowers all resistance but increases defense. And then this...
Well, my resistances are still really high, so I think it's worth it.
It's up to you. And if anything, you could just test. It does not decrease dark resistance, so there's that.
Yeah.
Power weight just sacrifices all defense for strength, and that's actually what I use. I've actually my setup by the end of the data battle was all power weights and the zero defense pro code.
I'm gonna put on the master belt.
You'd be surprised how what's it called? How many attacks still don't put you at 1 HP when you're at 0 defense pro code and all power weights.
Wow.
It's surprising. Game is surprisingly balanced with enemy attacks.
Well, this is like... It looks surprisingly goat-like, this item.
It's Xehanort. It's Xehanort's equipment.
Wow.
And all your items.
I think I'm good. I don't think I need to change anything else. I don't think I need to change my
I'll
abilities.
Lower the volume later. Don't worry.
Let's see, what's my time on my... Oh, I don't have food active.
Then do your favorites. Go to favorites. Okay, it's fine.
Yeah.
We'll just go without it for now. You can always...
I might not even need it.
You could always get the food later.
Yeah.
So, let's do it. Whenever you're ready, let's get right in. And we're in story mode now. This is story content. So pay attention.
Yeah. All right, let's go.
Okay.
Aw, here we go.
Oh.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, goosebumps. Oh, it's hard.
This place.
It's hard to watch.
Oh, Sora's here.
At least, I'm all here.
He looks like extra detailed right now. Like when you woke up, you could see like the freckles on his face and shit.
Hey! Is anyone out there? Hello!
Hey.
Huh?
Hey.
Who's that?
Where are you?
Over here!
Who the fuck?
I see you.
Oh shit. It's Yezora.
Hey, aren't you?
You know me?
Yeah, you're Yezora, right?
How do you know that? Who are you?
I'm Sora. And actually, there's something I have to ask you.
Sora? You're Sora?
Huh? You know who I am?
Sure. I've heard of you.
Interesting.
If you're here, then this can't be the real world, can it? But wait, that girl, she told me about you. Maybe you are real after all.
Are you done? No, this isn't the real world, and I am here. But this isn't what I really look like. How'd you recognize me as Yezora?
Huh?
Why are you using Sora's name?
Because... I am Sora.
If you are who you say, and it was fate that brought us here, then my path is clear.
Oh, fuck.
What?
Am I gonna have to fight him now? Oh, jeez. Yo! Yo!
Recognize it?
It's the fucking Shibuya place. Yup, we're on the tower.
Hey, wait!
I accidentally wandered into this place and went through some trials. Then, I was told to save Sora.
Huh? Then what's with the weapon?
Time to end this.
Grab your controller.
Oh, shit!
There. Oh, fuck. Now. This'll do it.
No chance. You thought you'd win?
Well, all
wait,
right.
Wait.
Oh.
How could?
Okay. So we're not expected to beat him.
Sorry, but I don't lose.
Welp.
I will save you.
So the guy who sent that message at the end of last episode was Yozora. When he was like, I will save you no matter what. This hella detailed texture.
I've been having these weird
thoughts
lately.
The fuck?
Like, is any of this for real? Or not?
What?
None of this makes sense to me.
And that is the end of that. So, Sam, what do you think happened there?
Yo! I don't even know. Oh, what the fuck?
Go to special. Peter. Very end. Falsus Rex.
Falsus Rex? Is that the thing we just watched?
No, press X. That's the block cutscene, as I've been having these weird thoughts lately. The whole episode is called Falsus Rex.
That's Yeah. Interesting.
What do you even make of this secret episode?
Yeah, I don't like. Okay, so apparently, whether they were in reality or not, they're like. Sora went to a realm that Yozora was in somehow, or something. Like, they like, I don't even know how to explain it. It's like, you know what this kind of reminds me of for some reason?
What?
You know that whole thing, that like semi-creepypasta of like, that dude from everyone's dreams or whatever, and then someone drew like an image of him?
Oh, that's not a creepypasta. That was like a study of the some person who's been appearing in people's dreams. Like, the average person who appears in people's dreams.
Yeah, and, like, it feels like that. like some weird shared consciousness moment. And then Zora's like, you're not Sora. Because he also says that Zora isn't, like, he isn't who Zora really is. Like he's not his true form, which is interesting because that's all we see of him. By the way, side note, I don't know if we ever talked about how interesting it is that Zora looks kind of like Riku.
Yeah.
Like down to the same outfit, basically.
Looks very similar.
So that probably has significance.
So that's the first block cutscene. I told you before that
there are two block cutscenes,
and it depends on what you do. I'm going to tell you the truth. You got one ending, and that... Which
so
is
you're saying I have to beat Yuzora yes. to get the other one?
Yes, you have to beat Yuzora.
Okay.
And we are not going to do that on Capture Card, so this is going to be this episode. So let's grab you the controller and we'll sync it.
All right.
All right. Ready?
Yep. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3. Respect.
Perfect. Okay. See y'all next time.
See y'all next time.